see many patients who have suffered recurrent pregnancy loss, which we typically define as two pregnancies that have been lost in the first trimester. Initially, of course, emotional support is provided for these patients, helping them with coping skills, helping them so that the stress and sadness isn't harmful to their partnership. But that said, oftentimes there are some basic investigations that can be started in these patients to look for causes. For some people, it's a hormonal cause. For others, it's a genetic cause. And yet for some, it's actually the shape of their uterus that can be contributing to the recurrent pregnancy loss. So we investigate these things together and put the whole picture together to follow to try and support their next attempt at pregnancy as best we can to help them manage the stress. A fertility treatment absolutely is known for being quite stressful, and we understand this. I like to address it head on. For my guidance to patients, first and foremost, I encourage them to surround themselves with supportive people in their lives. Maybe that's their family, perhaps it's a coworker, or maybe it's a friend. But at least if we can take fertility treatment out of the darkness and allow people to talk about it more openly and feel supported in their stressful days, that can be helpful. For other patients, it can go beyond just needing supportive coworkers or families. And so for those patients, we offer medication and actually professional counseling services outside of our office. I encourage them to reach out to support groups, both locally and regionally, and I encourage them to be proactive such that when they do have success, they reach back to this time and help others who are also struggling during their initial fertility treatment. Because fertility treatment can be so stressful to imagine the whole process all at once, I encourage patients to compartmentalize their treatment. And what I mean by that is that we have to think of small successes together. So perhaps it's just getting through blood work. Maybe it's just getting through the first ultrasound. Maybe it's getting through that X-ray dye study test. But each one of those are successes that really merit being celebrated because they're all part of the journey. So if we can compartmentalize treatment and help patients break it down so that it's more manageable, we can typically help them better reach their end goal with less stress. Having support from a partner is very important. And I think partners sometimes struggle with knowing how to better support their significant others during treatment. So in as much as it's possible, I encourage partners to be present at appointments, even if it doesn't mean that they're in the room. Perhaps they're on FaceTime or they're on speakerphone, something to engage in the experience and be able to support their partner through their presence, even if it's virtual, can be very helpful. I encourage patients to remember that it's so important as a couple to celebrate small successes, to still continue having date nights, doing things that they enjoy, engaging with social interactions and opportunities in their community, and not losing sight of who they are as a couple just because they're in the throes of fertility treatment. I find that these successful strategies can really help to support patients even when there's bad news, because in having strength in a partnership, it can really help them to have success in their long-term goals.